Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer and welcome back to Monster Hunter World. In the last episode, we captured ourselves an angry pickle. This guy over here. Now, I've got a different weapon than I did at the end of the last one because apparently I got a new room. This was the private quarters. Oh, it does go to the new room now. I got a new room, which I discovered because I wanted to come on here and practice with some other weapons. Namely, the great sword. This that you could put up animals and stuff. I like that. Now let's see which one he interacts with when I sit down to rest.
Hmm.
Now, I want to show something. The reason I was trying this greatsword out is there's something called a true charged slash. Which is apparently the most powerful attack you can hit with, as far as I know, with this weapon. I don't know, it may be in the entire game. But it's also extremely difficult to time it properly. I've done it by accident a couple of times. And here we go. It's the second hit from this. Apparently it can do a ton of damage. But yeah, that's apparently quite the powerful attack. And something I learned, I saw in a video that I didn't realize was a thing. The attack that you land when you're trying to wake up a monster does double damage. And I saw somebody landed a hit with a greatsword. I don't remember what greatsword it was, but it did. They landed a hit on an Anjanath and it did over 1,000 damage when they hit it, because they hit it in the head with that attack. And I was like, holy shit. Because I want to try that out. I want to see what I can do with that. Want to get Devil Joe stuff. I really do. I want to get more Devil Joe stuff, but I really don't feel like having to fight another one right now. Let me check something real quick. I did not get a... Okay. I didn't get what I thought I did. Talons of Fire and Ice, a Legiana of Ire and Ice, sorry. A Legiana and an Otogarin. I might just do these optional things that I've got just to get these out of the way. And then I'm gonna go with my hammer. Carapace Sledge 3. Let's go. Thank you. flaming. Dragonator confused. Okay, fine. Broke something. Ready to capture or not. Okay. Cool. I wonder if you can sever their tail. I'll have to look in the hunter's notes and see if it says anything about it. Check my field guide. Tail is severable. Holy crap. You have to have a pretty strong weapon to cut through its tail, though. Because otherwise it's just gonna bounce off of its... off of protection there, the armor. The bones, whatever.
Try hard, will you?
Was thunder and ice, and we've got fire for this thing. Thank you. let's go and do this one then.
Thank you.
didn't expect it to work like that. That works. That works. Wasn't quite close enough, but apparently that's one of the most reliable ways to land that last hit when you're trying to wake something up, is to do the pull your sword out right in front of it, roll away once, then proceed with the combo, turn towards it and proceed. That's the smallest one I've kept. Okay, sure, whatever. Oh well. Water fires 2 stars, so I could use this weapon on that thing. That's gonna be closer to it. Yeah, one of those spots I mentioned in the last episode that I found a new fishing spot here. There's one right here. And then the other one I mentioned that was in a pool of acid. Maybe it was the episode before that I mentioned that. I don't remember. One of them I mentioned it. Then I said there was one in a pool of acid. Was it this one? No, I didn't think so. I thought it was up in... Was it up in here? Or was it up in that other part? No, this isn't a place I can go. So it must be up in the other part. Fish down in here that you can catch too, which was quite surprising considering it is acid. This is what I'm looking for, I think. It doesn't bring me to where I want to be, but it brings me out here. here quicker than the other direction would have. From being down in there, it's quicker to go that way to get over here. Oh, shit, I forgot to put on the armor that protects against this stuff. Oh boy. Isn't that lovely? So I'm gonna have to be worrying about that the whole time. Gotta be right through here somewhere. There it is. Did I seriously just chase it right towards the thing I'm after, too? Really? Thank you. That's irritating. Ready to capture. Back here. Where are you going? Get up here. Really? Way. There we go. Got it. Then I'll just return to camp and do the next mission from there. That was the smallest one of those I've found, too, of course.
Are you okay?
This ought to be pretty easy. weapon needs to be sharpened, but I'm trying to do this without having to take me to do that, because it can be hard to find a chance. Yep. That wasn't too tough. That was actually quite easy. But then again, these are low rank monsters, which I shouldn't be having any issue with. Zorah Magdaros has appeared. I'm going after Zorah Magdaros then. Let me just double check. I'm pretty sure. Dragon and water. Okay. Yeah, I thought so. I'm going after Zorah Magdaros now. Let's do this.
Zorah Magdaros enough to capture it! Once you're on its back, give all you've got! Destroy the cores to weaken it! Or try dropping some of those stalactites on it!
Yes. We've rigged the stalactites with gunpowder! Use your slinger to blast them loose!
You can do it! Proceed with caution!
I got this.
Destroy the magma cores to weaken Zorah Magdaros!
The success of the whole operation comes down to how much we manage to weaken the target!
Located. Hey, partner! Something's happening to its shell. The flow of magma is changing.
All right. Hold nothing back.
Doing that thing again. Watch the magma, it's changing.
I think that means I can move to a different part. I didn't realize that before.
Drive off
Dirk Gigante.
Go!
Gotcha. I able to reach Zora's head right now?
Zorah Magdaros is getting back on all fours. It's continuing its advance. Watch yourself.
Time.
Wear down Zorah Magdaros as much as possible! This is the last bastion! No more second chances! If Zorah Magdaros breaches the barrier, all is lost!
I wanted to destroy the rest of its magma
corpse. Over here! Hold nothing back!
Okay.
Can actually get back up onto its back to actually go. I could probably destroy the last of the magma cores, but.
Okay.
I don't know if I really want to take the time to do that.
Thank you.
I should have brought a stupid bow gun. Ballistas are destroyed. Lovely.
All right.
Got it all loaded up here.
We have an emergency.
I forgot those go right over its head there. Shit. Did that hit this thing instead of Zorah?
Zorah Magdaros is charging up energy. Oh no.
There we go. That didn't stop it. I thought for sure that it did stop it. Good. I think the cannon over here is loaded. I think that's what that means when he says that. I think when he says that, it means that somebody finished loading a cannon. Not really an emergency, that's just standard procedure at this point. The barrier's gonna be getting taking damage. This cannon's ready to go. Let's fire it then.
Move.
Do I fall right through it? Right? Or it just does that?
All right. No, that was the wrong button. Or the wrong spot. I'm going to this tactic. Can't get to it right now. Great. So I shouldn't have come on here after all.
Please tell me there's some way to stop that attack.
Yeah, if I had been over there, I probably could have. I screwed up bad. Because I can't even get thrown off of its back right now. Ah, you come here.
Now! Hold nothing back!
It's not close enough, is it?
Hey, partner! Okay.
Yours. Okay. Let's get back up here. Fire off this cannon.
Okay.
Shit, this ballista's destroyed now.
Okay.
targeting that magma core on its head.
Zorah Magdaros is charging up energy. Oh no.
Not that thing. The other thing. Barrier's been destroyed, really? All because I went on its back. If I hadn't gone on its back, I could have done it. Of course.
Oh, you are too good to me.
Thunder and ice. Okay. And of course, because I failed that, I wasted that voucher thing too. Of course. I was being greedy and I failed the mission because of it. Lovely. It's nice to have that happen. Oh well, reminds me I'm not as good as I was thinking I was. I don't know why I took those things. It was an accident, I guess. It's nice to have a little reminder like, hey, you're not that good, you know? like how that gets me even when I'm looking the opposite direction. It's like, yeah, sure, that's how it works. How it didn't get me there, unless it's because I was behind the head. Apparently that's the trick, to get behind its head and it won't hit me with that then. That was still within its range even? Holy crap. I'm not broken that yet. Really? What the hell did that? Was that the flash bug that did that? Do they do it if I use a flash pod near them too? Huh. I didn't know that. When did you gather a blue mushroom? The Argosy is in port, okay. Zorah's appeared again, really?
Hail!
Hmm. think I'm going to do this one. I'll leave the Zorah Magdaros thing for another time. Flesh. That's a sign of an elder dragon, but which one would that be? Now I have a feeling that the Devil Jewel can break through that because it could break through barriers in other places in the other game. It will break through barriers and open up a new place. So I have a feeling it can do that in this one too, probably. Let's hope we don't have to find out, though. I'd rather not run into one of them right now. Considering I've got a bow gun, which I'm... Well, actually, a bow gun, I might be better off with a bow gun against one of them. Probably not, though. Thank you. things really aren't that hard to fight. Okay, that wasn't too tough. What else do we got? Let's do this one and then I'll do the other one too. I forgot to bring cool drinks with me. Ah. tougher than I realized. Forgot to bring cool drinks, which means in this warm area, my health is going to continually drop the entire time. So yeah, that was a bit of a major oversight on my part. Okay, maybe trying to use a bow gun on a Devil Joe wouldn't be a good idea for me, because I'm not very good with them. Although, then again, there's multiple enemies all at once, but a Devil Joe fights like it's multiple enemies all at once, pretty much. It's so fucking big, it's hard to avoid its attacks and stuff, so I think a bow gun would be a bad idea for me against a Devil Joe. As much as I would like to try it, I think I would fail. I wouldn't have enough ammunition with me to do it either. looks like the ones up there respawned. Killed one more than I needed to, even. Oh, I guess it's not dead. Now it is. Okay, then I can do that other one for the, what was it, 5 Barnos or something like that I had to kill. I know they want me to go after Nergigante, but I'm not really looking forward to that. Not yet. I'll get to it. Let's do this. trying to remember where more Barnos were. I think there were any up here. Completely missed them all. Can't kill you, huh? This one should. Really? You're tougher than I thought you were. They're tougher than I realized. They are high rank though, so normal ones probably would have died a lot quicker. What else do I have in this place? probably gonna play this some more in my own time again. Just because I want to get some of these these investigations and stuff done. I can gather materials and stuff. I can go on expeditions. Do that kind of stuff in my own time then, so it doesn't take up time in videos like this. Get those things out there if I go back out there. I want to go and get those ores real quick. I'll do it on my own time. That's it for this episode. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.